not going outside your camp. So did you hear Bannon's out?
That's too bad, huh?
I don't know. We've gotten rid of the A-team now, pretty much, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
I
he was...
Get rid of Sessions.
He hired the best, so there's...
Yeah.
Very few of them left.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. I mean, they get enough people in there that actually know what they're doing, that he might actually...
Like that article about the DOE that... I'd posted it as well, but... You know, Rick Perry in the election... There were three agencies he wanted to get rid of. He couldn't remember the Department of Energy, which he's now head of.
Right.
He had no fucking clue that, like, half of what they do is deal with cleaning up and securing.
Yeah, nuclear, yes.
And this story talks a lot about the Manhattan Project dump up near, very near Seattle.
Yeah.
And how they've got, you know, liquid storage, and each one's different, and they're generating hydrogen gas, so you could have explosions that way. Solid wastes in trenches that there's no records at all what's in them. And they had one of them collapse and had to push a bunch of dirt in, and now it's contaminated. And so that's like $3 billion a year sent to Seattle.
He knows they're gonna hire the best people.
Right. All the guys were sitting at their desks from, like, the day the election was won. Like, yeah, we think you probably ought to come visit once a week so we can help bring you up to speed. They came through on, like, a two-hour PR presser, and that was it.
Well, the thing that has me most pissed off is it's the State Department that keeps the peace. The military is for fighting wars, you know? And he's too stupid to understand that. He thinks the military can do both. And they can't.
As we've shown in several police actions over the last 20 years, if not more.
No, it's okay. He's up at Camp David deciding what to do with Afghanistan. Which is all good.
Tell George W. to come finish up his...
What he started?
Or do we backtrack and have him finish up Iraq first?
Yeah. All right, your hand all right? Your gear's all right?
No, my gear's only still going so far. I'm not sure quite what's going on.
It's not shifting?
It's shifting about 3 speeds.
Lows or highs?
I have the lows.
This is better than having the highs. Back then.
What is it with this guy? Every time I come out here, get
it's
on a bicycle,
you.
He walks.
It's you. I think you're
pushing the damn
X
thing.
On my bike.
It was my bike last time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. I was pushing her bike.
My sprocket went. My whole.
Yeah.
And it's bearing the sides of the wheel. I got a new wheel and it's fine ever since. Well, he rides his bike up here this time this year, and that's pretty much it. So. I ride mine every day in the summer. All right, let's see if we can get you back before it completely falls apart.
Yeah.
If we're not back in a little while, you'll know why.
The water is really high.
It is really high.
Yeah.
You've been down to the lake itself?
Yeah, I just rode down the little boat ramp.
But that bar down here, it's usually about 8 feet. You know, to waterline from the top, and it's gone.
Yeah, I'm sure. One time I rode right along, you know, out on the stone along the water. I'm sure that if I pulled that route up, it would be way underwater.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I was worried why racing route back on the trail starts down at the boat ramp. I'm like, oh shit, I may not be able to kick off this ride without getting wet, but. Just right at the water line is where I started.
All right.
maybe tomorrow. Need that. Halfway point.